Srivaru Motors, a Coimbatore-based startup, recently launched the Prana electric motorcycle. This motorcycle is largely targeted at the commuter customer segment. The Prana has three variants with varying ranges. The variants are named Class, Grand and Elite. The mid variant Grand is priced at 2.25 lakhs. Class, which is the entry level variant, and the Elite variant is a work in progress. The motorcycle can hit a top speed of 123 km per hour, which puts it in the class of 150cc motorcycles. The Grand variant claims a range of 126 km per charge, while the top and Elite variant are expected to have a range of 225 km. The drivetrain is a 72 volt system. The Prana can hit 0 to 60 in 4 seconds. It has a 4.32 kilowatt hour air-cooled lithium-ion battery. Around 2,000 to 2,500 cycles are claimed for the battery. The battery requires 6 hours 30 minutes to charge. The motorcycle uses a hub motor and has 4 modes: practice, drive, sports and reverse. The practice mode is for learners and limits the top speed to just 45 km per hour. The motorcycle weighs around 165 kilograms and has telescopic forks in the front and a monoshock at the back. Srivaru Motors founder and CEO Mohan Ramasamy said they wanted to build performance as a key differentiator. Our goal is to have our vehicles be the best in safety, performance, comfort and automobile design. Our vision is to have our automobiles number one in futuristic design as well as customer satisfaction. Our vehicles will be built using renewable resources, making them better for the earth while creating new jobs in green technology. Srivaru Motors has an experience center in Coimbatore. It is also looking to expand to other places like Chennai, Andhra Pradesh, Hyderabad and Kerala. The company has signed an MOU with the government of Tamil Nadu and plans to set up a factory in that state. So it looks like 2021 will be the year of the electric motorcycle, with multiple startups launching electric motorcycles. But we continue to get nothing but silence from pollution motorcycle manufacturers like Hero MotoCorp, Honda and Bajaj. Speaking of the design of the Prana, why does it have this large hump at the top which contains petrol in a regular petrol motorcycle? Why don't electric motorcycle manufacturers experiment a bit more with the design of their motorcycles? Number two, we spoke to some ICE motorcycle owners and they all said that they would be hesitant to buy an electric motorcycle because of the range. Electric motorcycle owners, as we know, tend to use their motorcycles in the city, but they also like to take it out of the city on weekends for long drives. So the Prana's 150 to 225 km range is pretty decent and might go a long way in convincing some of these hesitant potential buyers to go for an electric motorcycle. Overall, this South Indian company has created a pretty compelling product for motorcycle enthusiasts. However, the hub motor in the rear wheel is a bit of a question mark, especially considering that the motorbike appears to be built for performance. The battery size of 4.2 kilowatt hours is large compared to the Revolt RV400's 3.2 kilowatt hour. 100 kilometers range should not be a problem with a battery of this size, but the downside is that such a large battery will not be removable and the user will need to arrange for a charging point in order to charge the batteries. The company is expected to deliver to customers in March 2021 and we wish them the best of luck. Thank you.